To remain and learn to your more. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together in holy matrimony, Kimber Pace and Alicia Nix. We are assured that this action is commendable in the sight of Christ Jesus our Savior, but is not by any means to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, and advisedly, and in the fear of God. You may be seated. Divine revelation has declared marriage to be honorable to all. It is an institution of God, ordained in the time of man's innocence before he had been banished from the garden. It was given in wisdom and kindness to repress the regular affection, to support social order, and to provide that through well-ordered families, truth and holiness might be transmitted from one age to another. In this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined together. And so let us begin this blessed ceremony. Who gives this rite?
Our Mother.
Do you, Kim and Alicia, desire soberly and reverently to enter this marriage relation, determined to abide in love and purity toward each other, and to remain therein until death shall sever this bond? Answer by, we do.
We do.
The Bible says in Genesis chapter 2, verses 18, then 21 through 24, the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should live alone. I will make an helpmeet for him." And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof, and the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman. And he brought her unto the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." To which the Lord Jesus added in Matthew chapter 19, verse 6, "Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What God hath joined together, let no man put asunder." God's word provides the perfect rule for both husband and wife. Paul, by divine inspiration, has spoken in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 21 through 29, "Submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be through their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought a man to love their own wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hateth his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it even as the Lord church, the church." Kim, God has said in Psalm chapter 112, verses 1 through 3, something I believe that's just right for you at this time. "Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighteth greatly in his commandments. His seed shall be called mighty upon the earth. The generation of the righteous shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house, and his righteousness shall endure forever." Alicia, my niece, the Lord has a word for you in Proverbs chapter 31, verses 10 through 12. "Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, so that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of his life. May I urge you both to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation for a happy and enduring marriage. Your future happiness is to be found in mutual consideration, patience, kindness, and affection. I say to you this afternoon, cultivate one another's love by self-denying tenderness. And remember that living near to God will help you to live near to each other. Kim, will thou have Alicia to thy wedded wife to live together after God's holy ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as ye both shall live?
I do.
Alicia, will thou have Kim to thy wedded husband to live together after God's holy ordinance and the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou obey him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Having thus stated your willingness to assume the duties and responsibilities of married life, will you now unite right hands and give assent to the vows of the marriage covenant? Kim, you repeat after me. I, Kim, take thee, Alicia.
I, Kim, take thee, Alicia.
To my wedded wife.
To my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I plight thee.
I plight thee.
My troth.
My troth.
Alicia, repeat after me, please. I, Alicia.
I, Alicia.
Take thee, Kim.
Take thee, Kim.
To my wedded husband.
To my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
To cherish.
To cherish.
And to obey.
Obey.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I give thee my troth.
I give thee my troth.
What tokens have you as a pledge of these marriage vows? This ring is a fitting token of the marriage state. It is so fashioned as to have neither a beginning nor an end. It is made of such a material that will not tarnish with time or use. The passing of this ring through my hands indicates that you wish me to witness and seal these vows. Slip it onto a fourth finger, hold it there and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Okay, Alicia. It is. Hold it on his fourth finger. Slide it on. Okay. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Okay. Why don't you consummate this? Put it in the bench. Thank you. Face each other. For as much as Kim and Alicia have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to the other, and declared the same by giving and receiving rings, be it known unto all to whom these persons may henceforth come, that I, a servant of God, her uncle, his uncle-in-law, do now solemnize, seal, declare binding, and holy the wedded union of this man and this woman, and I do therefore by the authority of the laws of this state, sanctioned by divine authority, pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. May I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Kimbrew Pace. does.
I want y'all to stand up.
We stand to get a fully limo out.
Y'all just been married. Where are y'all going?
We're going to our reception.
Bye, Alicia. Bye, Kim.
We'll see you in a little bit.
We'll see you in a little bit.
Can I get you to step up to the sign so you're right in front of the Now, I want you to stand up and stand up in the top up there and wave.
Where are you going to ride, Kimber?
Oh, yeah.